Hello student, today I am going to start the reaction of metal with hydrogen. Reaction of metal with hydrogen. It is the chemical properties of metal. Chemical properties of metal. Clear? Now, when metal is react with hydrogen to form metal hydride, here metal react with hydrogen to form metal hydride. Clear? When metal react with hydrogen to form metal hydride, and when these metal hydride is dissolved in, and when these metal hydride is dissolved in water to form metal hydroxide, to form metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas. When these metal hydride dissolve in water to form metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Clear? That is the metal hydride react with water to form metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas. For example, when sodium metal Na is the sodium metal, when sodium metal react with hydrogen to form metal hydride, that is sodium hydride, NaH, to form sodium hydride. This is the sodium hydride. And when this sodium hydride, that is the NaH, dissolve in water to form NaOH, that is the sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Is the sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Clear? Next, reaction of metal with water. So next, chemical properties of metal is reaction of metal with water. Reaction of metal with water. In this reaction, when metal reacts with water to form metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas, as well as heat is involved, then metal is react with water to form metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas, as well as heat is evolved. Clear? Means in reaction of metal with water. Metal react with water to form metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas. For example, sodium and potassium react more violently with cold water. React with cold water to form sodium hydroxide NaOH plus hydrogen plus heat, and potassium react with water to form potassium hydroxide, hydrogen and heat. Clear? Now the reaction balanced. These two reaction means reaction of sodium and potassium with water is more violently because this reaction is the exothermic reaction. And exothermic reaction are those reaction in which heat is evolved. In this reaction, heat is evolved. Clear? So sodium and potassium react with water is more violently because the heat is evolved, and this heat is sufficient for hydrogen to catch the fire, and this heat is sufficient for hydrogen to catch the fire. So sodium and potassium react with cold water is more violently, whereas calcium react with cold water is less violently. Cold water is less violent because and to form calcium hydroxide and hydrogen gas plus heat. Here the calcium react with cold water is less violent because the heat is involved. This heat is involved is not sufficient for hydrogen to catch the fire. So calcium is less violently react with water. Whereas magnesium, third example, magnesium does not react with cold water. Magnesium does not react with cold water. Clear? It means, but magnesium react with hot water and to form magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Magnesium does not react with cold water, but magnesium react with hot water to form magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Clear? One important question will arise: why calcium and magnesium floats over the surface of water? Why calcium and magnesium floats over the surface of water? Then magnesium and calcium react with water, then hydrogen gas is evolved. When metal that is magnesium or calcium react with water to form hydrogen gas. Hydrogen gas. And these gas, that is the these hydrogen gas, is evolved the surface of metal, that is the magnesium metal and calcium metal, and the metal become weightless. So the calcium and magnesium float over the surface of water. Clear?